the result. Man is evolving by means of contact and experience. He expands. The dev is evolved by means of selecting contact. Limitation is the law for them. Man aims in self-control. Dev is must develop by need control. Man is innate in love and is forced to produce his coherency. The devas are innately intelligent. Forceful produces activity. G. The third type of force, metaphor, the balancing equilibrium of electric phenomena, has to play equally upon and through both dimensions. Within the one it demonstrates is self-consciousness, and in the other is constructive vibration. In the heavy man, these two great aspects of divinity are very blended, and in the course of the Mahaman Pantera, the imperfect gods become perfect. These broad and general distinctions are pointed out as they throw light upon the relationship of man to the devas. The devas of the physical plane were divided into the three groups A, G, C, are under another grouping spoken of as the devas of the seventh order. The seventh order is individually linked to the devas of the first order on the first plane. They are the reflectors of the mind of God of which the first order is the expression, and manifested as it has worked through from the 668 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. Archetypal flame. This seventh order of devas is directly under the influence of the seventh ray, and the planetary logos of that ray works in close cooperation on the larger lord of the seventh plane. As the goal of evolution for the devas is the inner hearing, it will be apparent why mantric sounds and balanced modulations are their method of contacting them, and of producing varying phenomena. The seventh order of devas is the one in which the workers on the left-hand path are concerned, working through vampirism and the devitalization of their victims. They heal the etheric bodies of their enemies, and by means of sound affect the substance, thus producing the desired results. The white magician does not work on the physical plane or form the substance. He transfers his activities to a higher level, and hence feels his desires and emotions. He works with the devas of the sixth order. The devas of the sixth order are those of the astral plane, and are the devas who have immersed in the forces which produce the phenomena we call love. Instinct, or the driving urge and motive which demonstrates later on the physical plane in activity at some times. Very positive vibration set up on the astral plane produces results on the physical, and that is why the white brother, if he works with the devas at all, works only on the astral plane and with the positive aspect. These devas of the sixth order, as might be expected, are closely linked with those of the second order on the monadic plane, and with the heart center of the particular heavenly man on whose ray they may be found. They are allied to the deva forces on the buddhic plane, and in these three great orders of devas we have a powerful triangle of electrical force. Three types of electricity which are met with an occult book. It should be borne in mind if you need memorizing. THOUCHTANDFIRELEMENTALS 669. Type of force at present an unknown type flows in from the Buddhist plane at this time, and the apex of the triangle is there. Triangle of monadic, buddhic, astral. These three orders are in this solar system the most potent, especially in this fourth round. They influence particular and in all three, it shows in its lower manifestation as the sex instinct is noted, and it inspires longing for union with God. These devas of the sixth order come under the special influence of the Lord of the sixth ray of abstract idealism, and it is their connection with Him which facilitates the working through of the archetypal idea onto the physical plane. Creative hierarchy likewise is specially connected with this particular order of devas, and through this dual influence is produced a physical manifestation which is definitely objective, one type of force working through the etheric manifestation, and the other through the dense physical. This will as yet prove an insoluble mystery to the student. In the significance of numbers much can be discovered. This angle of the matter should be studied in order to bring out the true meaning of this sixth order of devas. Her symbol is the six-pointed star set at a particular angle and in full manifestation. The six-pointed star is the sign that a son of necessity. 678 TRE ATISE on cosmic fire. No matter whether God or man has sought physical incarnation, the devas of the sixth order, the Agnidrians, are a prime factor in bringing this about. In the sixth round, these devas will begin to make their presence felt more and more potently, but the strength of their vibration will be very gradually turned upwards, and not downwards into the physical plane. This will involve the transmutation of desire into aspiration, and will produce eventually the liberation of the planetary logos, and bring a manvantara or the cycle of physical incarnation to a close. Withdrawal of the force of desire results likewise in the cessation of man's physical existence. The old commentary expresses this truth in the following words. The sixth retire within themselves, they turn towards the fifth, leaving the seventh alone. In continuing our consideration of these Devo orders, it should be pointed out that these three lower Devo orders, the lower fifth, the sixth and the seventh, have a close connection with the fifth. They are the building agents which, working on the involutionary matter of the three worlds, construct the lower three bodies of incarnating man. They are a branch of the lunar Pitris, but the fact should be remembered that this particular branch of Pitris is functioning in our particular scheme, and are closely allied to our planetary logos. Groups of these Pitris are found wherever man is in incarnation in all the schemes, but in other schemes they differ somewhat from ours, as the mystery of the planet is connected with a peculiar esoteric condition which concerns our own planetary logos. Wherever man is in incarnation, the builders of the bodies are to be found, but they will differ in A, B, their rate of vibration, their stage of development, consciousness, got done, a wrong and narrow idea is your fault. In future time, as may be seen from a study of the secret doctrine, 16 logo and septenary nature will be seen as the macrocosm for man, whilst the microcosm, man himself, will be seen also as the macrocosm for the three lower kingdoms. This is simply one way of studying the evolution of the conscious entity God, man, or lesser life by means of ego substance. It involves the study of the positive and negative interaction. As says the old commentary again, when father approaches mother, that which will be taken form, the union of the two consolates the true mystery of being. When the two great devils seek each other, when they meet and merge, the promise of life is fulfilled. When the one who sees and knows stands midway between his parents, then can be seen the fruition of knowledge, and all is known upon the plane of consciousness. When anew, the infinitesimal, is seen to contain Ishvara and his potency, when the lesser spheres and cycles expand into the 16 CS T I 288 2 178 2 178 7 678 2 ATREATINCONCIFIRE. Circle of the heavens, then shall the essential unity be cognized and manifested fully. When the one that holds the life becomes the free behind which that life is hidden, when the three by revolution become the 7 and the 10, when the 30 million crores of legal lives are equal revolution, when the central point is reached and reveals the 3, the 9, and the inner blazing jewel, then is the perfect manifestation consummated, and the 1 again becomes the 10, the 7, the 3, and the point. Herein lies the key to the mystic marriage, and to the student the occultism much may be revealed through the study of these pairs of opposites. The revelation of the process in time and space whereby this union and its fruit is consummated, and the resulting creation of the divine hermaphrodite is seen upon his own high plane. We must ever keep clearly in mind that we are dealing in this section with the evolutionary debit for the positive light animating involutionary matter or ego substance. Consequently, the correspondence of the mystic marriage of spirit and matter can be seen working out also in ego substance itself through the interaction of negative and positive ego lives. Substance itself represents the central duality, the form for the same duality, and when we arrive at man himself again, we have to to travel into. If this idea be extended to the solar system, it will be apparent that the asteroid of the different planetary logoi differ. And this difference is necessarily dependent upon the cosmic astral light, which directly affects the systemic astral or the side plane of the cosmic consciousness. This is a point that will realize, and the dense physical body They might be in